Okay.
All right. Today is June 29th, 2015. We are here in Cherry Hill, New Jersey at the home of Mr. Robert Fink, who is a World War II veteran of the United States Navy. Good morning, Mr. Fink, or good afternoon, actually.
Good afternoon.
So we're going to talk about your time in service. You are a veteran of World War II.
Correct.
Were you drafted or did you enlist?
No, I enlisted.
Why did you join?
Because I didn't want to wait until I was drafted at 18 and possibly going to the Army. I thought the branch of Navy sounded better, so I enlisted.
So were you under 18 when you enlisted?
I was 17. My father gave me permission, signed the papers.
Okay. Why did you particularly want the Navy?
Because I thought I had a chance of seeing more of foreign countries or parts of the world better chances than being in the Army.
Where were you living at the time you enlisted?
Living in the Bronx, New York.
Do you recall your first days in the service?
Yes, I do. It was in Manhattan, and we were being sworn in, and after the mealtime, they asked all those with driver's license to please remain. I did not have a driver's license, so I was able to leave, and those that remained had to do dishes. KP. So I was lucky that day.
I guess so. I'm just wondering what they had against people who had driver's licenses.
That's the only way they got enough people to do the dishes.
Where did you go for boot camp?
Great Lakes Naval Training.
Do you recall the boot camp experience? Can you tell me about it and how you felt?
Well, boot camp was very good for me. I liked it. I made friends, but not lifelong friends. However, upon departure from boot training, I was assigned to electrical school because of my aptitude test while in boot camp. And at the electrical school, which was at the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis, I did very well because I had recently graduated high school and could easily do all the math, which gave me a good rating. And when I left school, I was given a rank of electrician's mate, third class. And having never been out to sea, that was quite an honor at that time. Upon departure from electrical school, I was assigned to a new ship in Astoria, Oregon. It was a troop transport, and we set out from Oregon, eventually winding up in Honolulu, Hawaii. And there we filled up with a load of troops and headed for Aniwetok. And we made several trips throughout the Pacific. Went to New Guinea, in the liberation of the Philippines, several times into the Philippines. And at the signing of the peace treaty, we sailed from the Philippines past the Missouri into Japan with a ship full of troops for occupational duty at Japan. We also previously had supplied Okinawa with troops. The troop transport that I was on was basically for reinforcements or replacements of the various battlegrounds that had been secured. We also made two trips at the end from China, Shanghai, and Tsingtao with military and many civilians, many that were interred in prison camps by the Japanese. Many of those were missionaries, and we returned back to the United States twice. And then we went back to Japan because there were enough Army personnel eligible for discharge. And we had a troop transport full of Army personnel and sailed from Japan through the Panama Canal to Norfolk, Virginia. And I stayed there at Norfolk, put the ship out of commission, and then, of course, was discharged. I was one of the very few of the crew that was on the ship from the time it was put in service until it was decommissioned.
So how many years were you in? What year did you go in?
I joined in August 1943. I was discharged in April 1947.
So you were in for not quite 4 years.
Correct.
And going back to when you completed electrician's mate school, you were given the rank of a petty officer?
Yes, I was.
Okay.
I want to say also the crew was very good. I had good friends on board ship. We had very good food. We had a wonderful baker. And our electrician's shop was next to the ice cream room. So, needless to say, we were able to get extra gee-dunk rations. Gee-dunk is the term used in the Navy for ice cream.
How long was your boot camp?
Oh, I don't remember for sure, but it was August, October. I believe it was 12 weeks.
12 weeks?
Yes.
And you said that you liked boot camp? You enjoyed the things that you had
yes.
to do?
Yes, boot camp was very good, educational, because it's the first time I was ever away from home doing something different.
As an electrician's mate, what did you do in the Navy?
Oh, we took care of the switchboard, the auxiliary generator, the main generators, all the lighting, fans in the rooms, all the so-called Welland Davits or loading, what the deck hands use for loading and unloading material. We had to take care of all that electrical equipment. And there was one time there we were, several of us were sent over to a merchant marine ship because they couldn't get their anchor to go up. So we worked on the equipment and relieved solved the problem so that the merchant marine ship could continue on.
Did you see combat while you were aboard ship?
Actually, no. Our ship was always, 2-3 weeks after beachheads were secured. One of the major projects or whatever we want to call it we did was in Leyte, New Guinea. Now, Leyte, New Guinea is the last place that Amelia Earhart was seen. But there an RAF pilot apparently was shot down long, went far away, but he coasted all the way to Leyte and went in the water there. We rescued that pilot and towed the plane out of the way so ships could go in and out.
So an RAF pilot is a Royal Air Force pilot, correct?
That is correct.
So he's British?
Yes.
Okay. Were there any casualties on your ship?
None at all.
What was your most memorable experience?
I think walking around Shanghai, China, seeing a foreign nation, and yet much of it was established by foreign countries. I was fascinated by that, and also the city of Tsingtao, China, which I thought was beautiful. We sat there at the bay and anchored, and looking at the city way in the background was really purple mounted mountains. Just a gorgeous sight.
Were you awarded any medals or citations?
Well, we all received the medals for good conduct, victory medal, and the Philippine Liberation Medal. Of course, we were active in the liberation of the Philippine Islands. Made several trips to the Philippines.
You were talking about bringing back people who had been held prisoners there. There were a group of women that were held as POW, military women. Were you involved in their release at all?
I have no way of knowing who they were. They were out of bounds.
Okay. How did you stay in touch with your family during your time?
V-mail only. That's all we had was V-mail.
And what is V-mail?
V-mail was just a letter that you wrote down whatever you wanted to. And it was censored, so some items would be cut out, so it looked like cheese, Swiss cheese, when it arrived home. And it was free. We didn't have to pay any postage. That's the only communications we had with our family.
Were those the letters that they somehow shrunk down when they would arrive? They were very tiny?
Yes.
Okay. You said the food was excellent, correct?
Yes.
How about supplies? Did you have enough supplies to do your job?
Oh, yes. We had plenty of equipment. No problems.
And was it a high-pressure environment that you were in?
No, there was no high pressure whatsoever. So we just had to make sure that everything was functional, and the standby generator with the batteries would operate if necessary.
Was there anything special you did for good luck?
No, nothing.
Didn't carry a rabbit's foot or four-leaf clover?
Nothing at all.
No. Okay. How did the people on board ship entertain themselves?
Well, we had movies, and I was one of the two movie operators. So when we went into port, we would take one of the small ships, go to port, find the movie distribution place, and exchange film, and go back to the ship with a couple of reels of different movies. We would show them in the evening, and when we went to another port, we would exchange them the same way.
And were they current movies?
Yes, they were mostly current movies.
Did any entertainers come to the ship or come to your area?
No, none at all.
Were you able to ever get leave during the time?
Yes, we were in Seattle, Washington, because they had problems with the ship, and we had a week's leave. I went home, and then I went back to Seattle, and we sailed out again.
Do you have photographs from your time in service?
Yes, I do.
Were they photographs on board the ship, or...?
Mostly on board ship, also the places I visited, like Manila. I got pictures of Manila when it was destroyed.
Were you restricted in any way in what you were allowed to photograph?
No, not at all.
What did you think of the other sailors and officers that you served with?
Well, they were very dark. Electrical gang was good. We all got along. There was no animosity that I know of. And what was interesting was meeting shipmates from all over the United States and listening to them, like from down south, their accent. And of course, they were all catfish and hunters and catfish anglers. They hunted. Where I came from, the Bronx, well, I was a big city boy. And I went more for sports, because being in New York, we had good sports.
Did you keep any kind of a personal diary?
No, I did not. But the ship gave me one. I have a diary of the ship, what took place from the time we left to the time we came back.
It's a diary or like a yearbook, a ship's cruise book?
No, it's a daily log.
Daily log?
Daily log, yep. The amount of crew, we picked up some island and dispersed to another island and went to some other island and picked up so many Marines and officers and maybe a medical group and took them to another island, and I have a log.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Do you recall the day your service ended?
Yes, I do.
And where were you?
Norfolk Naval Air Station.
And what did you do?
I went through the routine of going to the dentist, going to the doctor, then seeing a lieutenant sign the papers and tell me thank you and goodbye.
And then what did you do? Did you stay in the area? Did you immediately go home?
I went right home on the Greyhound bus to the Bronx, went to work on the railroad, and stayed with the railroad. Being an electrician in the Navy, the railroads were just receiving their diesel locomotives, and they needed electricians because it was needed a lot of electrical work done, or maintenance. And I was put into the electrical gang, and I stayed there. And I worked my way up through middle management, and then I retired.
Did you go on for any additional schooling after you got out of the service?
I did some night college courses, yes.
Did you use your GI Bill?
No, I didn't have to because the railroad was paying for it.
Okay. Did you make any close friends while you were on board the ship?
Oh, I sure did. I made two of them. And one, we were friendly right up until he just died. And the second one, for some reason or other, wrote me a letter and said he was moving from Texas to be near his daughter in Oregon, but not giving me a forwarding address. I could not keep in touch with him anymore.
Okay. Do you belong to any veterans organizations?
I belong to the American Legion here in Cherry Hill.
Here in Cherry Hill? Okay. So you went on to do a career with the railroad after you got out. Mm-hmm. And obviously you got married, so you married and raised a family?
Oh, yes, I married a nice lady. Married 65 years now.
Good for you.
The marriage produced five very good children, all good citizens, all married, and all get along, and all are very good to us.
So you're from the Bronx. How did you end up here in Cherry Hill?
The railroad transferred me from where I was working in Harmon, New York, and from Harmon to Syracuse. I stayed in Syracuse 13 years, then went out to Detroit. And from Detroit, I was transferred to the main office here in Philadelphia. Then I retired.
Okay. Did your military experience influence your thinking in any way about war or about the military in general?
One thing I will say, I would advocate all youths at 18, 19, to spend 2 years in the military. They would learn respect, discipline, and tolerance for others. I strongly advocate that.
Okay. Do you ever attend reunions, or have you attended reunions of your ship?
No, I haven't found any. I've kept looking, but never been notified, and never see one in the American Legion magazine.
Is there anything you'd like to add or talk about that we haven't covered? Anything?
I will just say that I go to the VA once a year, and to me the VA has been very, very good. No faults whatsoever.
Okay. All right. That concludes the interview.